morning, my colleagues. I would like to grab this opportunity to officially introduce our ophthalmic lens solution, Isilon solution, to correct and help to slow down the progression of myopia. Just a minute. So, Myopilux. What is a Myopilux? Myopilux is an Isilon solution, as I said, one, to correct, second, to manage the progression of myopia. These lenses help a million of myopic children to slow down their progression of myopia worldwide. And it's a result of more than 10 years of research by international expert in myopic children. So Myopilux is a two different design for two different patients profile. So we have Myopilux Max, then we have Myopilux Plus. Myopilux Max, it's a prismatic bifocal, while Myopilux Plus, it's a short design progressive lenses. Before I move forward, just a quick and important note. This is not just executive bifocal. So don't replace it with the executive bifocal. It's a special design, as I said, and I will remind you one more time, to correct, yes, and to help to slow down the progression of myopia. Then, we have a Myopilux Plus. Again, it's not just the progressive lenses. The progressive lenses, you know, it's designed for adults, while Myopilux Plus is a special design for kids. So if you have a kid and you need to control his myopia, just the progressive lenses is not the ideal solution. You need to think about a progressive lenses especially designed for a kids, not the adults, and the solution in your hand, which is Myopilux Plus. So a bit of more details, we'll start from Myopilux Max. Myopilux Max, as you see, it's a two-part. The upper part is a prescription, the kids' prescription, to correct his far vision, his myopia. Then on the bottom part, we have, it's with addition, and here the addition is fixed, addition two, and based on a several research already Zach, he shared with you. In addition to that, there is a prism, which is a prism 3M. So it's not just excessive bifocal. It's combined with the prism 3M. We know this, the benefits of this type of lenses. It provides us a wider field of vision for far, even for reading. It's helped a lot to slow down the progression of myopia. And as per the research, and already Zach shared the research, and I will remind you one more time with it. It's a research conducted in Canada and China on 96 kids, and we split them into three groups. We put a group using just single vision lenses, other group using executive bifocal with addition two, and the third group using prismatic bifocal, which is addition two, prism 3M, and the results was there is a huge slowdown, which is amazing, 51, comparing with the kids wearing just a single vision lenses. So this is about the Myopilux Max. When we move to Myopilux Plus, as I said, it's a short design progressive lenses, and it's designed, as I said, and I will keep repeating it, for kids, not for adults, where we take into consideration the eye anatomy of the kids, one. Second, we take the facial anatomy of the kids, and again, the ergonomic of the lens. That's the reason the inserts of the lenses is totally different. The progression length of the addition is totally different. And it's, as I said, designed for the kids with our wave technology to provide the kids a comfortable while vision. And for your own phone, you don't need to mention the ad. The ad by default is there with addition two. So most of you will receive the prescription from clinic, hospital, or from expert optometry in myopia. You will receive it Myopilux Plus or Myopilux Max. You don't need to mention the addition because it's by default is there. When I say, for example, or when the, sorry, when the optometry, he decide I need to go for Myopilux Plus, which is means you have, or by default, it's a progressive lenses with addition two. In some cases, which is okay, we can go for addition 150. But by default, it's addition 2. Same as max, by default, it's addition 2, executed bifocal with the prism 3M. So just a quick overview between max and the plus. Definitely, it's worked for the all kids from the moment of the onset of the myopia. We can start with this solution. In terms of formula, here it's very important. For myopia plus, it's just for esophagia patients only. So you cannot go for ortho, you cannot go for exo with this solution. That the reason at the beginning I told you is two different design for two patients profile. Exo, it's a plus. When we go for exo, fovea, even exo, we can go for max. Means max, you can dispense to everyone, whatever his fovea. Yes, we prefer the exo and the ortho. Exo, we prefer it more to go for plus. When we come to the refraction error with max, we can correct it up to minus 6 and the cylinder up to 4. And you need to be careful here, the total power should be 6. So minus 6 with minus 1, sorry, it's not possible because the total power is 7, which is higher than 6. So just 6 is available, 550 with the quarter available or it's possible. So 6 and cylinder up to 4. Remember, the total power not exceed than 6. When we move to plus again, we can correct up to minus 8, same as cylinder, and again here, the total power will not exceed, again, minus 8. When we talk about anisometropia, we cannot dispense max if the difference is more than 150. So the maximum, we have a limitation in anisometropia, we cannot dispense if the and the difference is more than 150, while in a plus, we cannot dispense if it's more than 150. This is not a headache, this is a prescriber headache, but just for your info. And we cannot recommend this type of lenses for any binocular issue. What I want to focus here, especially for people that are working on a retail business, is not about prescribing, it's about dispensing of these lenses, which is really, really very important to manage and help definitely the practitioner or the optometrist to success with managing of myopia. It's about dispensing. So here, please, focus with me. When you receive the prescription with MyoPlus, plus or max, how you're going to correctly dispense these lenses. One, and it's very, very crucial. Number one, select the right frame. Select the right frame and adjust it well in your child face. When I say select the right frame, in turn one, the size of the frame, not big, not small, will sit on the shield nose. The arm, it will adjust it on his ear. So it's not slippery, it's fixed well. The size of the frame, it's enough. The position of his eye in the frame, almost in the middle. So I need enough distance between the pupil and the upper part. I need enough distance between his pupil and lower part of the frame. We highly recommend it, especially for Max, to go for a full frame, metal or plastic, we don't care, but we prefer something with a nose pad to be easy to adjust it. Avoid rimless completely, avoid semi-rimless, especially with MyoPlus Max, because there is prism 3 with add, so there is a difference between the upper part thickness and the lower part thickness of the lenses. Selecting the frame is really a crucial. Take attention, spend time to select the right frame and will adjust it on the patient's face. Second, we know it that very well, so PD, it's must. We know it clearly. Then here about the fitting height. Please, for executive bifocal, we should mark the lenses or take the segment height from the lower margin of the pupil till the deepest point of the frame. With adults, if it's adults, generally we do from the lower margin of the lens till the end part of the frame. For myoplex or in general for kids, it's from the lower part of the pupil till the end of the frame. This will explain what I'm saying. Till the end part of the frame. Some other practice, just follow the lower lids and raise the segments like 4 millimeter above. But the best practice, say here, lower part of the pupil. That's for existing bifocal, which is Myopilux Max. About our Myopilux Plus, it's a progressive lens designed for kids, and save any other progressive lenses till the center of the pupil. And here, because for kids, we also prefer to raise the segment height like 1 or maximum 2 millimeter above. So you are not going to make mistake if you raise the segment height a little bit above. But a big fault, big mistake if you reduce it. So a little bit 1 millimeter or up millimeter, which is great because it will fit the ergonomy of the child. So I have no problem. Make it lower, everything work. So segment height, it's really important, and I need to highlight the importance of select the right frame. Full frame is the best. Avoid completely semi and rimless. Plastic frame for me is the ideal if you are if the bridge sits well on the patient nose. That's it. And the product availability, you have the Myopilux Max on only airwear. You don't have a lot of variety in terms of index. You just on airwear. 1.59, which is the polycarbonate, our brand for polycarbonate. And the power range, as you see, it's up to 6 sphere minus 4 cylinder, total power 6. Minimum fitting height for Max, it's a 12 millimeter. When we move to the Plus, we have a little bit more variety, where it's a sphere up to 8, cylinder up to 4, and the total power is 8. Minimum fitting height is 14 millimeter. Means from the center of the pupil to the lower bar, it should be at least 14.5 millimeter. 13, change the frame. 14, change the frame. Selecting the frame is really a crucial to success with the treatment of, with management of myopia. You have a lot of variety in terms of the index, not like Max. Max, you have adjust one index, which is the airwear. Again, you don't need to mention the addition to SLR. It's by default. For Max or Plus, it's 2. In case, if the specialist need 250, he will mention that, so you will need to mention it to SLR. Other than that, it's by default, addition 2 for Plus, and addition 2 with the prism 3N for the Max. That's all about our solution. So please, if you have doubt, any thought, any questions, I'm here and happy to answer your questions. So any questions, guys, ladies? Is it clear? Yes?
Yes.
Thank you very much.